Hello children, today I will teach you in social studies chapter 12 natural disasters. So let us begin the chapter. In the beginning of the chapter there is one little exercise. Rearrange the letters to get the names of some natural disasters. First one is flood, then cyclone, landslide. Fourth one is drought, tsunami, blizzards. So write down the spellings correctly. So let us begin the chapter. Nature sustains life on earth, but it can also cause destruction. Forces of nature that cause destruction of life and property on earth are called natural disasters. Floods, droughts, eruptions, volcanic eruptions, landslides, cyclones and tsunamis are examples of natural disasters. Floods occur when a river or a stream overflows its banks and the water spreads to the surrounding areas. Floods generally occur when there is very heavy rainfall. Floods are also caused by the collapse of dams, blocking of rivers due to landslides, cyclones, tsunamis, and the sudden melting of snow on mountains during the summer season. Floods are very common in India, especially in northern plains. They cause damage to life, property, and crops. Diseases such as cholera, malaria, and dengue generally spread in areas hit by floods. So here in the next page, here is given and other side state affected is given. 2012 Assam, they are affected by floods. 2013 Uttarakhand, 2014 Jammu and Kashmir, 2015 Gujarat. We can prepare for floods in the following ways: listening to the radio or watching television for warning and advice, keeping a radio, a torch, a few matchboxes and candles handy, storing stocks of food and fresh water, assembling a first aid kit and keeping it ready for an emergency, drawing up a list of emergency numbers, switching off and unplugging all electrical appliances in the house. Trees should be planted as they prevent flood water from spreading fast. Special dams can also be built to check the speed of water. Droughts. What are droughts? Drought means occurrence of little or no rain for a long period of time. Droughts cause extreme scarcity of water. Drought affected areas have very few natural sources of water. Farmers are most affected during a drought as they are unable to grow crops. This results in a shortage of food, leading to a famine. To prevent droughts, we can do the following: grow more trees, develop rainwater harvesting systems, grow drought resistant crops such as sorghum, millets and maize, spray water directly on the base of the plants so that less water is used. The best way to fight drought is to develop effective irrigation facilities. This has been tried and proved successful in many areas of Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh. So children, today this much only. Thank you and have a nice day.